Angioid streaks are breaks in the degenerated Bruch's membrane. Which typically form around the optic disc and radiate from the optic disc as we can see in this image. These breaks have a linear appearance and resemble blood vessels, which is why they are called angioid streaks. In fact, angioid streaks can be confused for retinal blood vessels on superficial examination. Angioid streaks were first described in 1889 by Doyne, but the term angioid streaks was first used by the German-American ophthalmologist Jacob Hermann Knapp in 1892, so they are also known as Knapp streaks. Occurs bilaterally, but asymmetric. Angioid streaks are orange, red, gray, or brown in color. Associated fundoscopic findings may include orange skin pattern, is a diffuse mottling of the retinal pigment epithelium, usually located in the temporal mid-periphery. Also, optic nerve drusen. Peripheral subretinal crystalline bodies and focal atrophic spots. As we can see here, angioid streaks can be idiopathic or can be associated with numerous systemic diseases, the most common being pseudoxanthoma elasticum. A popular mnemonic rule used to remember the most common associations is Pepsi. Pseudoxanthoma elasticum. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. However, the recent literature has revealed that the association between angioid streaks and Ehlers-Danlos syndrome is weak. Retrospective studies have shown that angioid streaks exist in less than 1% of patients with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Paget disease of the bone. Sickle cell disease. And idiopathic. Angioid streaks usually are asymptomatic unless they are subfoveal. Complications: choroidal neovascularization, causing metamorphopsia and/or visual decline. Angioid streaks are a risk factor of severe subretinal hemorrhages due to rupture of the Bruch's membrane following a relatively mild ocular injury. Safety glasses are an advisable precaution for patients with angioid streaks because they can be highly susceptible to choroidal rupture following even minor blunt injury. Fluorescein angiography is an important tool as part of the evaluation in any patient with angioid streaks and visual symptoms to rule out associating choroidal neovascularization. Fluorescein angiography also may be helpful to clarify the diagnosis when the clinical findings are not definitive. Angioid streaks appear hyperfluorescent due to overlying retinal pigment epithelial atrophy. Angioid streaks are usually asymptomatic, requiring observation only. Laser photocoagulation has been used in selected cases of choroidal neovascularization. but the recurrence rate is high. Photodynamic therapy has been used in the past with relatively poor results and frequent recurrences. Treatment with anti-VEGF agents has supplanted the use of laser treatment of photodynamic therapy. Intravitreal anti-VEGF treatment is the mainstay of treatment with good results.